Roberta Parks, president of the Peoria Area Chamber of Commerce, is here with us today to talk about budgets and specifically city budget for Peoria. The city manager has produced a budget that is balanced, right. and this is great news. The chamber's been involved with the city and its budget and kind of giving recommendations for quite a while. Tell me what you think about the current budget.
Well, it was very interesting to listen to him make his presentation the night he talked about all of it. We have made many recommendations over the last 4 or 5 years, and the budget he has presented actually incorporates almost everything at some level of things that we've talked about before. Now, I understand that it's going to change some as it goes through the council process over the next 30, 40 days, something like that. He has, first of all, he's developed a way to, as best as you can, eliminate the structural budget that exists. Right. We've had budget deficits because of structural issues and because of the recession in the economy. Unfortunately, one of the ways of doing that, the primary way, is a significant reduction of staff. And that is never an easy thing to do. They're talking about somewhere in the neighborhood of 50 employees who will be laid off, and they've also
put
in...
That is going to be tough.
That's very difficult. Those are individual lives, people who've worked hard for the city for a long time, so I don't think any of us take that lightly. With that, obviously, he's have to put together some reorganization plans. You cannot continue to deliver services when you reduce your staff that much in the same way. And we have talked about reorganization of the staff structure, alternative service delivery methods, and both of those are included in there. Mm-hmm. Again, they some of them will make it through, some of them won't. But they've also looked at things like shared services with the county and with other organizations, what I would call managed competition, the ability to potentially privatize some services. He spoke specifically about engineering services and potentially building inspections. But I think with a managed competition way that the city will have a chance to bid on it also, see if they can compete with the private sector in doing those things. And one of the important things that he's done, when you have a recession, and the city did this, they delayed a lot of capital expenditures and improvements. And all of us do that in our personal lives also. Money gets tight and the roof's not leaking a lot, you patch it, as opposed to replacing
and
it.
And wait until
you have a little bit more money, till the economy comes back. And that's what the city's done for the last couple of years. But his proposal is moving money back into some capital improvements, specifically for overlays for all the major arterials over the next several years, which is, if you drive in Peoria, you know you're ready to do that. Now, there's always have to be some revenue increases. And what he's recommended, the council's had significant discussion on, but no decisions yet, is an increase in what's known as the garbage tax, from a $6 to $14. And we will be supportive of that. But I'd like to sort of a tip of the hat to the city manager for trying to address a very difficult budget situation. And we would encourage the council people to not stray too far from what his recommendations are. Look at them seriously. We anticipate modifications, and we'll be there listening and talking to him on those.
All right. Well, we'll look forward to hearing more as the days move forward, and hopefully we'll get the city's budget taken care of, and the chamber can continue to provide input on things like this for the city and others.
Great.
All right, Rob, thanks.